Paul, question. You ever, you ever have a time when you smoke? Ever smoker?
I've never smoked in my entire
life. Joker? Midnight toker?
Never.
Get your loving on the run?
Never. Evidently, I might start, though, if Josh keeps harassing me.
It's going to be kind of hard to smoke when he tears your lips off in one fell swoop and pulls your teeth out like Michael Myers in that new Halloween trailer when he holds them over the port-a-john and just sort of sprinkles them on the floor.
Yeah.
You're really tap dancing on a minefield today.
Try inhaling without lungs.
Mike, do you want to say who we saw, or do you think they'd rather remain
off
the grid?
I'll keep them anonymous. Okay. But yeah, I was walking out of an establishment the other day, and I saw somebody I knew, and I'm like, what are they doing just sitting on the curb? And they were smoking a cigarette, and they're actually older than me. They're in their mid-late 30s, and I've never seen them smoke before.
Man or woman?
A woman.
Could woman, write
and
it down.
I just walked. I was like, hey.
Starts with that letter.
I have no idea.
Hey!
But I mean, that could
be down.
Anybody.
That person right there.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's surprising.
Never seen them smoke, ever. And I guess they've taken up smoking in their 30s. And
wow.
I thought it was something that you stole a pack of your dad's Lucky Strikes and got on your bike and took off into the woods. And you and your boys, like, you know, hotboxed the Pall Mall underneath the overpass while the cars are ripping overhead. Oh, yeah, it's so smooth. Oh, yeah, I love that. I love that menthol. I don't know anybody that's taken up smoking later in life unless something's happened.
Especially now when it like, you know, it's going to kill you.
Right.
It's a given.
Like you're going to die because of that.
You just decide suddenly you want to be cool.
Yeah. Look at this. I'm a badass. I mean, Mike smoked for years and just hides it from us, but
what?
He hasn't just started smoking. He does it regularly behind our backs.
That is not true.
That's 100%. And I had my moments when I was younger. If other people were kind of passing a jack around, I'd be like, yeah, I'll heat that dart or something stupid. But why did you start smoking later? I know people have moved on from smoking to the vaping thing, which those devices have all but just quit trying to look like cigarettes. I went to the Renaissance Festival, and I thought I saw a guy sucking on a computer monitor. It was so bad.
How long before they come out with they're worse than cigarettes? Right? Is that another 6 months?
That's a
another
whole
year?
Yeah. Other conversation. And at some point, yes, you're going to grow mushrooms off your brain, even though you talk to the people that do, and like, oh, no, it's like a salad.
Well, the other thing, too, is I saw this person smoking in the morning, too, which is a more of a senior smoker move. Like, typically, you don't start out smoking first thing in the morning. You kind of work your way down into the morning
Yeah, that's people that take, like, a horse to work, enjoy a nice cut of fish, and light Ike.
Yeah, until eventually you're lighting up before you even step out of bed.
It's 4 o'clock, time for dinner. Yeah, that is an old-ass move to smoke that early. Let's go to the phones. 410-338-1098. Who's been holding for a sec? Let's talk to Spencer in Sparks. How old are you right now, Spencer?
I'm going to be 48 next week.
Oh, wow. When did you start smoking?
Well, I started last year, around the time that Spiegel lost Pumpernickel. My dog died of cancer. My job started to suck. You know, I'm not proud of it, but unfortunately, I can't do the wacky tobacco because of my job. So I sort of, picked up this ugly habit.
Damn, so the stress got to you?
Did my situation contribute to you starting?
Actually, you guys are part of my stress relief. I love you guys. Off topic, I want to go back to Mike Anderson's birthday batch of that woman that put you on blast, Justin. I love you, and I don't think you dominate the show. I think you guys all work great together as a team.
Best Mike, putting him on hold. We're giving him something. I don't know what it is, but he is an absolute sweetheart. Oh, my God, you made that guy smoke.
Way to go, Josh.
Way to go, Josh.
Way to go.
Hell yeah.
Hope you feel good about yourself now.
That's what I'm talking about, buddy. Huh? Hey, when you smoke, you do lose a little bit of weight. So that's... You could just do Slim Life, but I guess that guy decided to pick up a pack of Pall Malls or maybe some Parliaments. What are some other trashy cigarettes you could suck on? God, 47.
40. I mean, what do you do? Like, what's the...
At that point, your lungs are already black from breathing in a half a century of soot.
What like, drives you, and what is the thing that, like, you pick the cigarette up and you light it for the first...
Josh.
There has to be...
100%, Josh.
I can't imagine that... Somebody just goes blindly into a store and picks up a pack of cigarettes. You've got to have friends who smoke. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, hey, give me one of those,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's got to be something in your environment.
You see someone around you just looking so relaxed. Like my buddy Pete, Waldorf Pete, he would smoke a cigarette prior to going to the bathroom. It was his favorite thing in the world.
My number two does not look like a number two.
He said a cigarette would help relax his body, and it would literally just open up his system.
It would just roll out.
And it was just a storm surge coming out of his body. And I would look at him sucking on that thing. Well, hello there. And he looked to be so relaxed that I'm not going to smoke. I've tried. I coughed myself inside out. But in that moment, I looked at it like, God, you look like you're relaxed, right?
Almost worth trying to do it, right?
Almost
to see
worth
if it
trying
would be, because that would be worth it.
Fight through the coal miner black lung hack to get to that state of nirvana that you're in right now. I mean, he would take that first drag. His mood would change. He'd get like goose pimples, nipples get all hard. He'd start sashaying around the room like, God, that looks satisfying. But I guess our buddy there, who when he was dealing with what he dealt with and kind of felt like he was in lockstep with Josh at the time in mutual tragedies, he said, you know what? Screw it. Hand me one of those Marlboros. Let's do it. Well,
and you know, the other deterrent that just didn't exist 10, 20 years ago is the fact that people now look at you like you are complete trash.
Yeah,
that is true.
If you light up a cigarette.
That is true.
They do look at you like you're just chewing on a bag of hair.
It's become like taboo to do it.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
And that's the one thing that's always tough when you go to Vegas, like when you go to the casinos, is just breathing in the smoke.
Yeah.
Because now around here, it's like you never experience that anymore because it's just banned.
Bet it all on black, baby.
But yeah, out there, it's like even the littlest bit drives you crazy.
No one will know the sexual sensuality that is the 47-year-old 2.5-pack-a-day widower's rasp.
Hey, young man, I don't have enough money for a tip, but I can maybe take care of you in other methods.
They'll never know just how sexy that could be. I mean, Mike, you like and are attracted to pure, unadulterated white trash. I mean, I remember that girl we talked about a couple years ago
that worked at Starbucks that I thought was the coolest thing ever and essentially stalked. She was a smoker, and I thought she was so cool. And
gosh,
she had tattoos.
She was cool.
She was so dangerous.
I'll be back in a second to help with that macchiato, Mikey. I bought you an iced tea. This is from me to you. You want me to cough on your chest? I'll do that. I'll cough on your chest.
Yeah, spit in my face.
Oh, God. Let's go to Denise in Bowie on line 4. Good morning, Denise.
Hey, good morning. How are you?
How old are you now, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, this is my friend. I'm old, but she's also old. She's 47, 48 starting.
Oh, you're 47 years young, my sweet. What is it with 47, by the way? Why is that
the
sweet
magic
spot?
Number.
Why
magic
is
magic number.
Why did she start smoking so late in life?
She actually had a little issue with alcohol and she stopped drinking. So she had to pick a new addiction, you know, pick an addiction, any addiction. And she went to that. And, you know, it's, I guess when you're not broke enough, you pick a $7 a day habit and that'll put you right over the edge.
Does she have that sexy rasp to her voice now where she's kind of got that kind of guttural growl when she speaks?
Sadly, no, not yet. Help me pick out a shot glass for your father. No.
Oh, that's hysterical. Mike, I would need that audio in the system, please.
That's the other thing, too, is I don't even know if I wanted to start smoking.
And there
right
went
now.
Paul. It's time for a news tease.
Ah, goodness. Ah, goodness. Coming up.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.